In 1952, Ed Wilson and I started graduate school at Harvard at the same time with the same professor. And in a matter of weeks, we were fast friends, going to movies together, Chinese restaurant together, but more important than anything else, thinking bugs together. He was way ahead of me. I mean, he had a master's degree, and he had read just about every one of the salient books in the biological sciences. So for me to be with him was the learning experience of my life. And then we were to embark on a very happy and very fruitful experience. We took a 12,000-mile field trip to the United States in a 1942 Chevrolet with 160,000 miles on it. It burned a quarter of oil every 100 miles. I used to go to a gas station, say, fill up the oil and check the gas. And we crisscrossed the country. I forgot how many states we visited, but we went across the northern route, then turned south, came back through the moist southern terrain, and it was an extraordinary trip. The car didn't go over 45 miles per hour, so to get from one place to another would take twice as long. I was the only driver, so it was exhausting, but it was also exhilarating. Conversations were on biology, Wilson being as systematic as he is. For example, I'd stop because I was out of cigarettes. He would come out of the store with a little book, 50 Ways to a Better Vocabulary. It's paid off for him, two Pulitzer Prizes. And we'd sit down, he'd have Comstock's entomology book, and we decided we would learn two families of insects per day. I mean, to this day, some of my memory bank still goes back to being filled with experiences on that particular trip. There were jocular moments, too. Wilson was fascinated by bears. I've got a wonderful picture of him standing chest to chest with this bear, holding a slice of bread, which the bear is gingerly grabbing and eating. We were, in fact, feeding a bear through the window, slices of bread, and I was clicking away with my father's Leica. And we decided we wouldn't give all the bread away, so we stopped, and the bear wanted more, so it shifted its weight, put all its weight on one paw, which was on the window. The window gave like a piece of paper. This huge paw comes down on Wilson's chest. And I'm sitting there at the wheel, literally terrified. Wilson looks at me, and with the calm of the ages, says, "Eisner, you might as well start the car now." And I remember this as if it was yesterday. But it was also the kind of experience where every observation connects with something. We were both enamored with insects. He, of course, was collecting ants for his thesis. He was revising a genus of ants. And I was also collecting ants because he had actually influenced me to the point where my thesis ended up being on ants. So it was biology, 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 and very little sleep. There were also funny moments. He was the world's authority, or about to be the world's authority on ants. He slept on the ground in a sleeping bag. I always opened up a cot. I had terror of snakes. So in the middle of the night, I hear Wilson is awake and going, "What is this?" And he starts slapping. We turn on the lights. And he was in the path of a column of army ants, I think it was, which had picked none other than Ed Wilson as part of their trajectory. Well, that was a trip.